When I was in high school, by the grace of God, I met this young African-American Christian who every day would tell me about Jesus. Jesus this, Jesus that. And I said, go away. I don't want anything to do with it. That didn't stop him. He was a fierce movement for the Lord. He was poor. Everyone in his church was poor. Other members in this inner city mission were former prostitutes and former dope fiends and alcoholics, blind people and cripples. It was, you know, I looked at everyone and, oh my goodness, there's no one here who has anything good going for them. But they loved me. They showed me the love of Christ without ever sharing scripture with me. My friend Jimmy knew that. He knew that if he would start quoting scripture, I would be out of there. And so the blind person told me he could see. The crippled person told me he was whole. The former prostitute talked about second virginity. What the heck was that? I had no idea, but they had every idea who Jesus was and what Jesus could do. They came alongside of me. They established a relationship with me. They offered me hope. I never knew what hope was, but on and on I saw hope and faith and trust in someone that I didn't believe in. And I finally surrendered after four long years. What they did was they came alongside of me and deaconed me. Because they knew the love of God, because they knew how God had transformed their lives, that church knew what to do. But that's not always the case. Whenever I consult with church leaders, many don't know what to do. They ask, what is our biblical responsibility? And what isn't our biblical responsibility? What would you do in this situation? What would you do in that situation? How do I avoid compassion fatigue? Many deacons say. What do I do to avoid burnout? I'm almost there. And other questions similar.